is there for us. We'll review and then add those last two on. If there ever needs to be rebuilding, there needs to be rebuilding right now of the Lord's church, doesn't there? I'm not flattering you when I say this, but when I come here and hear the warmth and see an almost full auditorium on a Wednesday night, I don't know how to tell you how much good it does my heart. Because I travel a lot, and a lot of places I see big buildings with very few people, once strong congregations who are now down to 10 or 12, people who put out good preachers, and the singing is dead. And where the singing is dead, the congregation is dying with it, is my philosophy. Your singing's not dead. But I'm telling you, the church around our area, around the area where I am, we need some serious rebuilding. And we need some serious leadership to do it. And the first thing we got to do, not the last ditch effort, but the first thing to do is the first thing Nehemiah did is pray and get God's blessing and find God's way. Secondly, we can hope to have some government leaders on our side and work for that and vote for that. Thirdly, we need leaders in the church to step up with a passion about getting it done. And not just talking, but getting it done and rebuilding after COVID, rebuilding after decades of decline in the church, rebuilding after whatever might have happened in any particular local congregation. We need that. We need it now. I don't often pound a pulpit, but we need that. It breaks my heart to say it and think of some of these places. We need that. We need that leadership. We need purpose. We need work. And we need a strategy. Did you notice that they had the strategy of defense, but there was offense? Have you ever noticed that the armor of God in Ephesians chapter 6, where we have to put on the whole armor of God to stand against the wiles of the devil? Because man, did you notice through this story, the devil never quits. So you put on the whole armor of God. Did you notice that 5 out of 6 of those pieces of armor were defensive? Having your girded your waist with truth and putting on the breastplate of righteousness and having shod your feet with the preparation of the gospel of peace and taking the shield of faith with which you are able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked one and taking the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit. That's the only offensive weapon, God's Word. The rest of it's defense. You got to have a good strategy. And then you got to be vigilant. Be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil, walks about like a roaring lion seeking whom he may devour. The end of all things is at hand. I don't understand from 1 Peter 4, verse 7, but I think maybe this might be part of it. When you're in these trials and you think, I've been preaching 30 years, and every decade people thought this is the end of all things. Seems like things have to come to an end. They're getting so bad, seems like they have to come to an end. Okay, maybe the end of all things is at hand, but just be sober and watchful. Be serious and watchful in your prayers. Don't let the devil get just a little bit in. Keep him on the run. Get behind me, Satan. Keep the Word of God in your heart with the offensive weapon and put on the shield of faith and all those other things and do the work of the Lord. If you're not a Christian tonight, let me tell you why I get so riled up about this. People are going to hell. There is a heaven. There is a hell. And Jesus said most people are going to hell. We desperately don't want that for anybody. But most people are going there. It's the church's job to build walls, not to keep people out, but to build spiritual walls that allow people to come into the spiritual city of Zion, the Lord's church, where they can be there, be encouraged like you are, encouraging one another tonight. Be helpful to one another. Get people through this life and on their way to heaven. This is a warehouse, this building is, or this congregation is, if you will. And you bring people in it. They're baptized into Christ. They stay here 30 or 40 years. And then they go on to what they were aiming for to start with. It's a warehouse. It just comes, you keep going and pushing out. And it's sad when somebody dies, but we don't sorrow as those who have no hope. You're not a Christian. Your only hope is to be a Christian. You're not going to find any hope anywhere else. Confess a faith in the Son of God, repent of your sins, be baptized for the remission of your sins. If you've done that and you haven't been unfaithful and made yourself the center of your universe instead of the Lord, repent and come back. Please, let us help you. Come forward as we stand and sing.